Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Thank you so much. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you with us, and I thank you very much for that lovely kiss. Someone told me the other day, they said, you know, you shouldn't be kissing those girls because the flu is really coming in an epidemic form. And I said, well, if you're going to go, that's the way to go, right, gang? We have three wonderful couples for you today as our want, and here they are, winning money today for the blue section, Mr. Steve Allen and his wife, Jane Meadows. Steve, welcome.
Thank you.
Certainly is.
Sound like we're making up a telegram.
Yeah.
Bert, nice to see
Bert.
You.
Thank you. Jane?
Yes, dear.
How are you?
Fine, thank
you. If you're ready to go, because I think, you know, if we get right off the bat here, we can win more money and get things
yes,
rolling
here. Yes, let's go.
And I know that
win.
Everybody here wants to win, and you can't help it. You get carried away, you want to win.
I'm feverish with excitement.
It's a natural thing.
I think, and I'm a poor loser, so come on.
That's right.
I'm a rich winner, so let's get to it.
Okay. Winning money today for the banana section from On the Rocks, Mr. Tom Poston and his wife, Kay.
Let's go, bananas! Let's go, banana. The yellower, the better.
What is that that it says on your shirt there, Tom?
This is one of the finest golf tournaments I've ever had the luck to play. It's Duff's in Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Oh,
great golf tournament.
Uh-huh, okay. Well, I hope it brings
you luck. I still owe them for the sweater.
I see. Well, now they know where it went, don't they? Kay, how are you, love? You all set to go?
Just fine, yes, indeed.
And now, this is the first time. Is this your first time on?
Oh, no, we were here yesterday.
Yes.
We were going to be dynamite.
No, I wasn't going to say that, but I'll accept
oh,
that answer.
Oh, you mean for...
That's don't you remember?
It's a funny answer.
Anyway, I assume you're ready. Winning money today for the red section, the star of SWAT, Mr. Steve Forrest and his wife, Chris.
No. Oh, no. Second. Yesterday was...
Well, Steve.
How do you do?
I'm doing well, sir, and I know...
If I were Gordon Hathaway, Steve could do his show.
I know that...
Yeah, that's right.
I know that SWAT's doing terrifically well, and congratulations for that, and I know you are, too, and it's nice to have you back.
Welcome thank you very much. It's a pleasure being here.
Chris, if you're ready to go, here comes the first question.
Okay.
It's for you, ladies. It's worth $150. Ladies, this could never happen.
Oh.
Look out. But let's suppose you went to every man you know, married or single, and propositioned them. Okay? Now, wait a minute. How many of them do you think would say, okay, all of them, most of them, a few of them, or none of them? Okay? This could never happen, we say. But let's suppose you went to every man you know, married or single, and propositioned them. How many of them do you think would say, okay, all of them, most of them, a few of them, or none of them? Think that one over, ladies, and we'll find out. Ooh, you know, that's not a bad question. I think it's kind of an interesting question. I hope you find it interesting too, Steve.
It's a home-wrecking question.
That's what it is. It's our standard home-wrecking question, Steve. What do you think Jane will say?
Well, there's so many component factors to this equation that I'd like to get off the stage.
And it's complicated, too.
I'm concentrating on either few or most. There is a shred of moral dignity left in our society. But only that much these days. So I would say, after all, Jane is very beautiful, and if this horrible thing were to happen, I would say most, meaning at least more than 50%.
Right, okay. Most of them, okay. More than 50% of them is most of them.
Do I count? I would.
Not you. We didn't. We're not. Oh, wait a minute.
I count for anything.
Hold on.
Most of you.
Most of the panel, half of the panel, or... No, no, no. Most of them is your answer. Here comes Jane. Well, Jane, you have propositioned every man that you know, married or single, and we want to know how many of them do you think would say okay? All of them, most of them, a few of them, or none of them?
Well, certainly not all of them would say it. That would be ridiculous. And I hope it wouldn't be none of them. I think perhaps A few of them.
No, you're being too kind on yourself.
Most of them?
Most of them, Steve said. Maybe he knows them a little better than you do. He said most of them. Sorry about that. You lose for the Blues, but you come out a winner anyway. Tom, what will Kay say?
Oh, I would say, automatically, I would say all, but I know some of our friends are out of their minds, so they wouldn't be all. So I would say most, because my friends are very, very healthy. Very healthy and very sane.
Yes, now you will say most of them is what he's saying.
Ding.
That's what he meant to say.
None of that.
Bing, bing, here he comes. Here she comes now. Well, Kay, you certainly have been busy. You have been propositioning every man you know, married or single. And we want to know how many of them you think would say okay. All of them, most of them, a few of them, or none of them.
I want to know how this rumor got out.
We have ways of finding out.
Nothing personal, darling.
No. It's just a hypothetical question.
I'm afraid the banana section's in trouble. What he thinks and what I think, or what he thinks and what I know.
Wait a minute.
It's getting better. Don't say anything.
A few.
No, that's not what Tom said. Do you know what Tom said?
He said most.
That's right.
He doesn't know.
But you see, the best thing to do is for you, the person in the back, to tell the truth. They're the ones who are asking the questions. So
No names.
Sorry about that, Tom.
Yeah.
She said a few, you said most. So there's a few guys in there that are questionable. Steve, what will Chris say?
Well, I think it's, this is a home-wrecking question. And, of course, they've got some insider information on this thing. If they didn't come through, I think it'd be crazy. I'm going to say that she would say they all would.
All of them?
Yeah.
Well, all right. I like that. That's fun. Okay.
Terrific.
You know a lot of guys who can't wait, eh? Okay. Gee, if it ever comes
up, I think she's pretty cute.
I think so, too. That's terrific. You'll say all of them.
Sure.
Okay, here we go. Why not? That's
fun.
Got nothing to lose. Nobody's got it right. Chris, no one has gotten the question right. You can get the whole $150 for the red section. What we want to know is that you've propositioned all these guys that you know, married and single. How many of them would say okay? All of them, most of them, a few of them, or none of them?
Oh, this is a terrible question. I'm going to take a big fat guess, and I'm going to say... most of them.
No, he said all of them.
You're bad.
Nobody got it right. Don't worry, gang. This $150 goes over to the next question, normally worth $150, making it worth $300, and we'll come back and play it. And everybody came out fine. No problem. Still have a tie. We won't have a tie for long, though. Come back after this question for you.
Grab your phone, scan the code, and vote for Viewer's Choice and your chance to win.
All right, no one got the first question right. That one comes over to this one, making this question number two worth $300. And here we go. We have a three-way tie. Zip, zip, zip. Ladies, this is it. Here's an observation question. This is a cute question. Is the first item of clothing your husband puts on in the morning always the same as the last one he takes off at night?
Oh.
Is the first item your husband puts on in the morning always the same as the last one he takes off at night? Okay, off you go. We'll start with you, Tom. What will Kay say to this one? Are you going over it mentally in your mind?
I don't know. I'll say yes, because the alternative is no.
Good thinking, Tom.
Let's be positive about this. She'll say yes.
She'll say yes. It is the same one. What item is it for fun?
Just makeup, a little streetwear.
A little street makeup.
Yeah, the same
understand.
As I take off the night before.
So, K7, all right. No, you'll say it is, yes, the last thing.
Well, it's just got to be a guess. I don't even know myself.
You don't have a routine that you think you follow?
You think I should say no? Well, one of us is 50% right.
You're going to say that she'll say yes, it is the same. What would it be? Socks, underwear?
Socks, I guess.
Yeah.
Underwear.
Or socks. Certainly not your pants, unless you're... That's really weird, isn't it? Put your pants on first.
A wig? No.
No, it wouldn't be your wig. All right, you'll say she'll say yes. Here she comes. Shh, don't give it away now. Okay.
Yes.
Have you been thinking about it?
Oh, yes.
All right. In the morning now, I mean, is the first item of clothing that Tom puts on in the morning always the same as the last one he takes off at night? Yes or no is the answer.
It's a yes or no, right. I got that. The word there that confuses me is the always.
Uh-huh.
All right.
No, I don't think there is an always in
yes,
there.
Yes, you read it. There's an always.
Oh, yeah, I did.
Always.
You're right. There is an always in there. By golly, there
See,
it is.
Always, I mean, you know, so predictable. I'm going to say yes.
Right. That's it. Oh,
good. See, I don't know which one
you
it
see,
is.
See, that's the fun of it, because you picked out the one word. I didn't even realize it. Always does make it interesting, doesn't it? You said it is. What is it?
I said I don't know what the piece of clothing is.
Oh. But he always puts it on first and takes it off
definitely.
Last.
Definitely.
That's why I said it was a guess between yes and no, because the always confuses.
True.
Oh, ye of little faith.
Thank you, Kay. You have a share of the $300. Steve, what will Chris say?
She's gonna say yes.
Yes, it is the same. What
she's
is
gonna
it,
say
Steve?
It's the same.
What is the item that you put on first in the morning and it'll take off last at night?
You ought to know. It's a,
how so would I know? Wait a minute, clear that up, will you, Steve?
The
if
first
you don't mind.
Thing you put on in the morning is the same thing. Your shorts.
Your shorts.
You put your shorts on in the morning, you take them off at night, right?
Yeah. Well, sometimes, yeah.
Look, if you got a nice rug, it's not your socks, your shoes, it's your shorts.
Yeah, that's true. I always, if you're in a hurry, Eric.
It's
Jamie,
my shorts.
Yeah. Okay, it's gonna be the shorts. I mean, it's gonna be yes.
Yes. Oh, it better be yes.
Here she comes now. Huh? Chris, what will it be now? The answer is the first item of clothing that Steve puts on in the morning the last thing that he takes off at night? Yes or no is what we want.
Oh, this is an easy one, Bert. And you don't want us to tell you what the item of clothing is, do you?
Sure, why not? I think that'd be kind of fun. But what is the answer first?
Well, I won't tell you, but the answer is yes.
That's right.
Don't be coy. Tell him. I did.
Now we'd like to know what the item is, Chris.
Well, I think it's pajamas and shorts.
Pajamas, the first thing, he puts
pajamas
on pajamas in the morning?
Sure.
Whoa, okay.
Right.
Well, whatever turns you on is fine with
farther
me. Thanks,
that,
Chris.
Farther than that, I'm not prepared
Steve,
to go.
Steve, what will Jane say?
I would think after 20-odd years, and they've some of them have been very odd, 20-odd years of marriage, during all of which time I have, like Steve, taken off the shorts and put them on in at the right order, that Jane would probably have noticed that and therefore will say yes.
Yeah, but it was different shorts on those 20 years.
No, I wear the same pair. Every afternoon at 3:17, she launders them and hangs them out in the backyard. What am I talking about?
All right.
But yes is definitely the answer from my mouth at this time.
Right, okay. That's good. From his mouth, we have a yes. Let's see what we get from Jane. Jane,
yes.
What will it be now? The question is, does Steve put on the first same thing always, the first thing in the morning, and take it off last at night? Is it always the same item, yes or no?
It's that word always that bothers me.
Let me say it exactly how it's written here. Is the first item of clothing your husband puts on in the morning always the same as the last one he takes off at night?
Usually, yes.
That's right.
Yes, always.
Yes, that's
yes,
usually
yes.
Yes, yes,
yes. Is that what we have?
Yes.
Then we have a three-ways is what we have, and we have a three-way tie at halftime, gentlemen. If you will step to the rear, we shall bring the ladies out front. We shall come back. It's still tied, but it's not going to stay that way. See you in a moment. All right, here we go. We have changed places after halftime. I have the ladies with me, and we have a three-way tie, which makes it kind of fun. Fellas, this question is for you. It's worth $150. Here we go. Men, you're shopping in a department store, and you've been waiting several minutes for a sales girl to help you. Finally, she says, "Who's next?" You are. But a woman next to you says, "I am." Would you be more likely to speak right up or say nothing and let the woman take your turn? Okay, think that one over and off you go, fellas. We'll start with you, Chris. What will Steve say to this? What would he do in a case like that?
Well, Bert, he's a nice guy. He would be seething, I think, underneath, and he'd say it's really my turn to himself. But I think he'd let her go first.
He would?
Mm-hmm. I think he would.
What about the next one?
The next time it happened?
I mean, the next lady. Suppose another lady tried it. Not the question. I was just curious.
Well, I think with the next one, he might let the other one get by with it. And finally, the third time, perhaps he'd
yes.
say,
"Gee,
now it's my turn."
The moral is don't be the third one. Because when Steve gets angry, you'll say he will let her.
I think so, yes.
Okay. All right. The question is, sir, you are waiting in line. And the sales girl says, "Who's next?" And the girl next to you says, "I am." What would you do? Would you speak right up and let her know in no uncertain terms that you're next? Or would you let that woman take your turn?
I'd let her take my turn.
That's right. Took a long time, but he got the right answer. You got it, Steve. What will Steve do, Jane, in a case like this?
There's no doubt about it. He's a pushover. He would let her go ahead.
He would.
And he would criticize me if I did it with a man, you know? He would say to me, it's not your, turn, wait. But he would let the woman go ahead.
Oh, that's an interesting point.
Yeah.
And probably true. I think probably we
all...
You
men are all alike.
Oh, I wish you said that. Okay. You will say he will let her take
He would
his
let
turn.
The lady go ahead.
Here he
The
comes.
Woman. We don't know if she's a lady.
Yes, that's true. Steve, what would you do? Now, you're standing there. Who's next is the call. And a voice next to you, a feminine voice, says, "I am." What will you do? Will you speak up or will you let this woman take your turn?
It's very difficult because if it were an older woman or a very young child, I would let that person go first, of course. But I'll assume that you just mean, let's say, a 40-year-old woman. In that case, it's tough because this is women's lib time and women don't expect to have favors done for them anymore. But I'm trying to think of what Jane would say, right?
That's right. But she has to try and figure out what you're going to say, because I asked you the question.
Yeah, I see. Well, nevertheless, that goes both ways. In that case, then I'll say I would let the woman go first.
Oh! That's right. That's what Jane said.
And he would.
That's what the lady said. We still have a tie.
Yeah.
Okay, what will Tom say?
Oh, he's very gallant. He would let the lady go first.
He would?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy, if he gets this right, we've got a three-way tie, folks. Here we go. Here he comes. Tom, what are you going to do now? You're waiting in line. The sales girl says, "Who's next?" And a feminine voice next to you says, "I am." And you are. Would you speak right up and tell her about it, or would you let the woman take your turn?
It depends on the degree of embarrassment that I would happen to be feeling at that time.
Yes.
Kay once sent me to the store to buy bras for her. And I let everybody in the place go ahead. But I think normally, I wouldn't be saying what I was thinking or feeling, but I would normally keep quiet and let the lady go ahead.
That's it. You got it. Everybody got it. We split it three ways. We still have a three-way tie, and we'll come back with the $300 question. We got to break the tie then, I think. See you in a moment.
We'll be right back. Mazur's created the very first ever National Game Show Day.
This is a very, very special day for us.
It all starts June 1st on Buzzer.
All right, we have a three-way tie. We're going to break that tie momentarily. This question is worth $300. Fellas, here we go. Man, which of the two of you is a more aggressive driver? You or your wife? Don't say anything. Off you go. Goodbye, fellas. Oh, well, I think some of you seem to feel you have this one. Jane, what will Steve say?
A more aggressive driver.
Yes, aggressive is the word.
Aggressive driver meaning speeding and things like that?
What's probably this? Lane changer, a passer.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, no doubt about it. Me.
It's you. Really?
He's a very, 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 very conservative driver.
Uh-huh.
And I go very fast and in and out of, you know,
yes.
Do everything wrong.
Right. It's you.
Yeah.
Here he comes.
Oh, I hope he
Steve, mm-hmm. Between you and Jane, which of you is a more aggressive driver?
Don't even have to pause to think on this one. Jane is.
That's it. You got it. Absolutely correct, sir. Okay, between you and Tom, who's the more aggressive driver?
Oh, boy, is it Tom.
It is.
Oh,
no,
my seatbelt goes on. I go like this.
Your hands over your face.
You
Here
bet.
He comes now. Tom, between you and Kay, which of you is the more aggressive driver?
The answer is so definite. I could really do a number on her by saying it was Kay, but it's not. It's me.
That's it. <You're> gonna... Scared everybody to death, Tom.
No, it's me.
You're right. Still have a tie, two-thirds of a tie, Chris. Between you and Steve, who is the more aggressive driver?
Well, he'd better answer this right. He is, very definitely.
He is the more aggressive driver. Here he comes now. Between you and Chris, Steve, who is the more aggressive driver? This will make it a three-way tie. I don't want you to feel any pressure, however.
As one fully insured, I am.
That's right. You got it. Everybody gets it. We split it three ways, and by golly, we have a tie. Three ways. Doesn't happen very often. We'll come back in a moment, divide the money three ways. Please don't go away. See you after this message. We had a three-way tie. It doesn't happen very often. Everybody won $250. We had $1,000. The rooting sections, all three, will divide $1,750. And that's nice.
Where this is, we had a three-way tie, a four-way cold tablet, and a five-day deodorant pad. And I think that's pretty well.
And I think it is, too. And you have something wonderful we should look for, Steve. You have on PBS, I believe.
Oh, it's a new TV series starting in the fall called Meeting of Minds.
Meeting of Minds, starting in the fall.
He's the producer, the writer, the
everything.
The oh, really? Oh, the whole big... That's brilliant. Wonderful. We'll watch for it.
Do you have something new coming up?
Yes, I do. And we're going to talk about it soon. But I think we're out of time. We better get out of here. Thank you all for coming today. We'll talk to you soon. Come and see us on Tattletales, won't you? Bert Convy saying so long, everybody. Bye.
This is Gene Wirth speaking for Tattletales. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program has been edited for broadcast. We'll be right back.